Hello and welcome to the next tutorial. Today we are going to be making these fidget hexagons. I know they sound kind of awkward, but they look amazing. And if you want to know what kind of filament I'm using to make these, they're included in the video descriptions. There's a link below so I can take you directly to Amazon to show you which ones I've got. Now this fidget is going to take about 6 steps, and the first one is going to be the hardest, in my opinion. The steps are going to be listed up here. That way you know where we are. And let's get started. You're going to want the polygon. So we're going to drag it over to the work plane. And the goal here is to make a starter. To make these, you actually need these sides to be pointed towards the center. And since we don't have anything like that, we have to make our own. So we're going to click here on this hole. We're going to click here in the center and then 30. We want the height to be 30. Now I'm going to rotate this one 22.5 degrees. So here it is. And notice I don't have to do anything. It automatically goes to 22.5 as long as I'm within the blue circle. If I go over here, it doesn't actually go to 0.5. See, it goes 22, 23. But if I'm inside the blue circle, automatically. Now, here's the next thing. I have to make sure that these two, actually, I'm going to click the letter D to make sure that this is touching the ground. And I'm going to zoom in because I want to see, you see this right here? I want this to be on that blue thin line. And I've already taken the snap grid off and I'm going to move it over so that this one, the end of this one is over. So it makes it easier for me to see right there. Let me look underneath. Yeah. Okay. Now I'm going to move this one right there as well. Now I'm going to zoom in just to make sure, see, I'm off a little bit. So I'm going to use the arrow keys on the keyboard to move them over, and almost there. Now I'm going to look at it from the side and see. That looks good. Now I'm going to duplicate this, Control or Command D, and then click the letter M or this button right there, and then use this arrow here to make it go in the other direction. It's already 22. I'm going to hit Shift, and actually I'm going to hit the shift button and then drag it over there with the mouse. I'm going to try to get as close as I can just by looking at it, but then I'm going to make sure it actually is. I'm going to use the arrow keys now on the keyboard to move it over to the left, right there. All right. So now I've got to do the same thing with these two right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate these two, Control or Command D. I would duplicate it, and then I'm going to rotate them 60 degrees. Right here in the bottom, it says negative 60. If I would have gone positive 60, it would have gone the other direction, and it would have been fine. Okay, see how it did not work out? Both of them are still selected, this one and this one. So if I move one, the other one's going to move. But check this out. I'm going to use the arrow key and move this over so that it is right there. Almost there, right there. I'm going to check the other side just in case I made a mistake. I want to make sure everything is good. Okay, now they're both selected. I'm going to hit Command D, and they're going to rotate again. Did it work? No. But I'm going to move it again with the arrow. This time I'm going to hit Shift and the arrow key. It moves it just a little bit faster. It's just not as precise. Let's see. Yeah, almost there. No, arrow key and there. Okay, now that I have all these done, what I'm going to do is I'm going to group. Let's see if this works. And it worked. That's amazing. Now the little top is cut off and that's fine. So that's the end of step one. If you thought that was hard, well then it's going to get easier. The next step is to resize this. Now I'm going to hit Shift and do a shimmy. This is very important. If you don't do this, only one side is going to get larger than the other. We want it to be the same. So I'm going to click 100. Notice I'm doing it on the right side of the shape. And the bottom one doesn't actually change into 100 because this is not, this didn't start off as 20 by 20. This started off as 20 and 17 point something. The important part is the one on the right, see, is 100. And now I'm going to click away. Now click back on and change this to 48. Okay, now this is how you're going to start this. Okay, now I'm going to duplicate this, Control D, and then shift it over here. And I'm going to make it a hole. This one here, notice right here, it's still 100. I'm going to do the shimmy, right? Right there, hold the shift key and drag this over, and then change this to 97. Notice the bottom number also changes, and that's fine. Now the numbers that I'm about to change right here, because I need to copy this and have six copies of this. The numbers are going to be over here on the right. That way, if you get lost, you can just look over here on the side and continue with the video as long as, you know, I'm still making these shapes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate this and then drag it down. Now, mind you, this is going to happen a lot. Duplicate. Because I didn't click away, it's just going to do it for me. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And one more is 6. Okay. Now I'm going to change the shape. So don't forget, very important that you need to do the shimmy every single time. The next set, by the way, we're now on step 3 because we already created our first set. Now all we're going to do is resize the rest of them. So step 3. I'm going to do the shimmy. Change this one on the right to 88. Hit enter. This one is going to be 85. Enter. This one is 76 after the shimmy. 76. And then this one is going to be 73. This one here, I'm going to do the shimmy. This is going to be 64. Very important. I'm always working with the number on the right. Again, shimmy, and this one's going to be 61. Shimmy this one, 52. Shimmy this one, and it's going to be 49. And the last one. This one's going to be 40. And this one is going to be, after the shimmy, 37. All right, that was the end of step number, what was that, 3? Now, beginning of step number 4, I'm going to select everything, click the letter L, and now they're all centered in this direction, but not in all directions. See how it's sticking out right here? So here's what I'm going to do. Step 5, I think. No, step 4. So we're going to group each one. No, actually, this is still step 4. So I'm going to click the letter L, and this is gray. That means it's already aligned. So I'm going to click here and then Control or Command G, or you can click this one right here. I'm going to click the letter L, gray, and then group. L, click, and then group. Click the letter L here and Command or Control G. Here, the letter L, and that's both gray, Control G, that's grouped, and then this one. I'm going to, align and Control G. Okay, now all of these are going to be, this is actually step 5. I'm going to align them and make sure they are in the right place. So letter L, they're all aligned. And here on the side, we're good to go. Let's zoom in. That one looks correct, right? They're all good. I'm going to move this over a little bit, just to the center of the work plane. Now, I'm going to drag one of these and I am going to try to cover all of it. Now make sure you look around. You don't want to miss a piece somewhere. I'm going to drag it up a little bit. Now the numbers don't really matter as long as it covers all of it. And then look down here because I'm going to want this number to be 10. Some people just move it up. I'm just going to click the number and then change it to 10. Hit enter. And then I'm going to group both of them. Notice I selected both. Group, Control G, or that one right there. Actually, that one. All right, so now I'm going to move this up again. I'm going to change that to 10. Now I'm going to duplicate this. This is now the last step, Control D. And I'm going to rotate. Notice I'm staying inside the circle. And click the letter D on the keyboard. Now I'm going to group this. Now, what we've produced is these hexagons are a little bit thinner than the star tutorial. The star tutorial, these were thicker, and that was because we changed our numbers by 4 going to the right. Now, if you want those numbers and you want to do the same exact thing with those, I'm going to put them in the video descriptions. That way you can, you know, change yours if you want to and make it a little bit thicker if that's your choice. Either way, I hope you'll like and subscribe to these videos. I really would appreciate it. And thank you for trying it. And please try our other fidget designs. And I hope you have a great day.